Hey guys, it's Deborah. I'm outside in my backyard with my kids, so you probably will hear noises. I just wanted to talk to you briefly about something that I feel like the Lord has put on my heart, which is that the time that we're approaching, I feel like with our prayer, we can change things. Well, of course we can change things, but change them drastically before we leave. So this is, right now you're seeing people in Brazil pleading with God to remove the virus. And I just, when I saw this video, it really captured my heart. And there's another video I want to play for you that just really felt, I felt strongly about, like it was a good thing and that it was right. And I'll play that right after this one. So, yeah, basically what I feel like I'm being shown is, until we leave, we are going to determine what it is like to some extent until we leave. So I'm not talking about changing prophecy. I'm not talking about changing what's actually going to happen that says in the Bible. You can't change that. But our prayers change so much. And I feel like he's showing me. Sorry, my kids are screaming. I feel like he's showing me. Lila, too loud. I feel. Lila. Too loud, please. I feel like he's showing me that basically the way, and it revolves a lot around the United States, the way that things are going to go down till we leave is going to be drastically different whether we pray or not, because of President Trump, whether he's going to be in office or not and how that all goes down. You know, should the Lord tarry, and we're still here till the election. But there's been, like, I don't know if you guys heard of Dana Coverstone. He's a pastor who did a video that went kind of viral about a dream he had. I'm not doubting the dream is from the Lord. I don't love that there's no interpretation of it. Really, it's just kind of laid out there. And the only thing I heard was, you know, get guns, stock up on food, things like that. I don't love that. That doesn't sound like the Lord to me, but it does sound like he was being shown, like, the tribulation. That's what it sounds like if you guys have seen his dream, Dana Coverstone. I'm not doubting he saw that. I just don't love how it's being put across, you know. And that wasn't, I don't think, his initial attention, but it's being put across YouTube kind of like, just, here's my dream, it's horrible, it's terrifying, and that's it, laying it out there. And then the only other thing I'm really hearing is, you know, I heard him talk about getting guns. You know, so that's very American, because I'm Canadian and we're not even allowed to, well, you can own guns with a permit or whatever, like, I don't know, we don't own guns here. So I don't remember how it really works to get a gun, but it's not the same, it's not at all. So basically, that was one thing, and stocking up on food and stuff, I've never been told to do that unless it's like minimally amount. And you know, there's plenty of people who can't stock up on food, so, and water and all this kind of stuff, and there's homeless people and lots of different reasons they can't. But I just felt like it wasn't very clear, the interpretation of it. So anyway, I didn't want to talk too long on that. I just don't like when people build up fear, and I'm not saying he's doing that, I'm saying, like, just, it just doesn't, I don't like that it's being posted on everybody's channel, but they're not really addressing it, like, where's the rapture and all this, like, what are you saying? Because what he was saying was vultures were eating people and crazy things. Like, I just think if we're going to post it on our channel or something like that, we really should talk about it a bit more, and some do, but we shouldn't just post it and be like, there you go, there you have it, end of, like, people, it's putting people in a lot of fear. And like I said, what the Lord was showing me more was focusing on the prayer side of it, that we can control and we have so much power, you know, to change the upcoming events, but not like the prophetic events, but how we leave. That's how I look at it. We can change how we get out of here. We can get out of here in a disastrous way, or we can get out of here in a more prosperous or like revival type way. And I don't mean like everything's going to go great. I just mean like when it comes to winning souls and how the state of the world is and how bad it could be before we leave. That's all I'm saying. And I know for sure he is telling me to tell people about prayer and how it affects our destiny. Not prophecy, but just the near future. So anyway, I want to play this rabbi. He is a Christian, and he just had this dream or word from the Lord on this. And then after that, I'll come back, talk to you again.
Shalom. This is Rabbi Maurice Sklar, and it's 12:31 at night. I was praying for, you know, as I do before I go to sleep, before everybody, and then the Beit Rafa. And And right after midnight, I got a very strong word of warning, and also it was accompanied with a vision. This is the clearest the Lord has spoken to me in quite a while, as far as current, something current. And the Lord says to, and he said, get on right now. It's July 1st. We just went into July 1st. And the Lord says that the next 5 months up to the election, there is a coordinated, planned, very deliberate, step-by-step takeover of the United States, that the left and Marxism, and the whole point is to stop President Trump from being reelected. And they know, the Democrats know, that they will lose the election. And there is an all-out attempt, the Holy Spirit said to me, to overthrow the government, overthrow the whole thing, to stop America as we know it. And the Lord says to not only, we have to pray, we have to fast and pray. We have the next 5 months, we must humble ourselves, we must pray. And the Lord said to warn them, it's coming, it's already, these things are set in motion, and it's been planned for a long time. And we need to cry out to God for his miracle intervention right now. I believe this scripture that says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. And, you know, I'm the last, I don't like to predict doom and gloom, but I saw what I am to tell you is, also there's another level that will come towards the end of the summer of increase of these birth pangs. And then there's another one when we hit September. And, what we do right now, the people of God, we must intercede like Abraham, he did for Sodom. I mean, you don't take heed and know that this is very real. God shook me tonight. He shook me and he said, as we enter into July, this is on a razor edge. It could go either way. America can have a rebirth even, but not with this haughtiness and pride and arrogance and defiance, no. And of course, we cannot stop all the birth pangs with our prayers. We are in the end times. We are in the last days. We are on the border of the tribulation. It has been restrained.
So, like I said, well, let's talk about the restraining first. 2 Thessalonians 2:6-7. What is restraining, withholding? And now ye know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. So that's what that guy was just saying. Something's restraining. God has been restraining. And we see what is restraining, which is the Holy Spirit, until he's taken out of the way, which is in the believers, when the day of night comes. I've said it before that I feel like it's like symbolically, like we're like a dam holding back the waters, and then when we go, it breaks. This is kind of the visual that I've gotten, you know, of us holding back the full plans of lawlessness. And like I said, it's biblical, prophetically, it's not going to fully come to fruition until we leave. But I feel like the Lord is showing people right now that how important prayer is. Like, I think sometimes when you're watching prophecy, you forget how important prayer is and that you can hold things back. You can have the power to do things because he's given that to us. And I think because you watch we watch prophecy, we think, well, things are just going to happen because they're going to happen. But we forget that we have a part to play. Like, that is something I realized that he's trying to say. You have a part to play in how you leave. It's going to really determine how you play this part. You know, what if our prayers can help us to leave in a more peaceful manner? So I think, like I said, it just feels like, you know, we're holding things back. And once you just give in and say, you know, prophecy is going to happen as it's going to happen and there's nothing you could do about it, you can get into the mindset of just kind of sitting back and waiting and watching, but not actively, you know, participating in spiritual warfare. So Michael is, you know, going to be fighting and standing up and doing the work. He can't just say, well, prophetically, you know, this is what's going to happen. I'm going to win. He has to actually do the work. Like, God doesn't want us to be robots. So yeah, it wasn't like supposed to be a guilt trip. I just want to like say to you guys that I feel like the Lord's saying that we can pray ourselves out of here in a certain way, and not to get out of here, but just like how we leave and how the conditions are. I think we can change a lot. And so I'm not exactly sure what to pray at this time, but I'm pretty sure it's something to do with about these elections. So we should just pray about what to pray as well. You know, pray in the Spirit, pray in tongues, ask the Lord for guidance from the Holy Spirit, because we are going home soon and this is meant to be encouraging. So I'm gonna end this with an encouraging little compilation song that I put together. But so just stay tuned for the end. But yeah, mainly I just wanna say that there's no point in going through struggles when we have some spiritual power. It doesn't mean we can make everything just as we want it, but I feel like he's saying there is a level of control we do have. So let's just use that. Like, let's not sit back. But again, if you pray in the Spirit and ask the Lord, what is it I should pray about? That's a big part. But let's not get into that mindset that, well, prophecy is just going to happen. So whatever. So I feel like what that rabbi said is correct. I feel like watching those people from Brazil moved me, because he's saying, you know, like one time somebody asked me if I could pray for the virus to end and do like kind of like a, it was like a message that you send to other people, you know, where you send it to like 10 other people to pray. And my first reaction was kind of like in my head thinking, well, you know, it's part of God's plan or the prophecy or whatever. And then immediately I felt a bad feeling about that. Like, no, you can still participate in, you know, this world, like you're in it still, like participate in the prayer for things to be better while you're still here. And it's, you're not trying to pray against prophetic events. You're trying to do what he's asked you to do, you know, pray always without ceasing over many different things. So anyway, didn't mean to go on. I think the main thing I just wanted to say is that I think I'm asking you guys all to pray about that evil people don't succeed with these elections and whatever they might be doing against Trump, or if it's not against Trump, if it's just God's people, if it's just the lawless one trying to get into position earlier than he's supposed to, whatever he's trying to do, I'm not sure. So I think that's just our job. Like, we're still here. The light of the world is still here. Soon the night will come when there'll be no more work and the light of the world will be taken out, which is us, the Holy Spirit. We are the light of the world. Well, he's the light of the world shining through us. So I think that's it. I just wanted to cover that and just also mention about that Coverstone, Dana Coverstone, that whole thing. If you didn't see it, I'm not even going to like promote it right now, because I'm not saying it's not of the Lord. Definitely I'm not. I just, there needs to be interpretation of it. There needs to be prayer around it. Say like, what is he seeing? Time periods. He says November. He talks about dates. But he's also talking about crazy things like vultures eating people outside or whatever. So that is, they could be different events at different time periods. And to just lay it all out there without giving more, it's I don't know. I don't know what to think. I think there needs to be interpretation, and more people need to step up and say, this is how we see it. Because he's not stepping up and talking about the rapture. He's not talking about his view. On his, I think, Facebook page, he talks about it or something, but he doesn't talk about where he stands with all this, so it could promote a lot of fear. Like, I don't know. It sounds like he just was trying to share his dream with his friends, and then it just got out of hand. So I'm not going to, like, go on about that. I just wanted to focus more on the thing that I saw with Brazil and then what I saw with this rabbi. And I think it is very true that we have our part to play and we should participate. So let's just get on that for the next few months. Like, let's, the guy was saying 5 months, the rabbi. So I don't remember when his video was made, but let's just get on that. So let's just be in intense prayer for the Lord's will to be done, the lawless one not to prevail, and for many souls to be saved. So yeah, that's it. And yeah, so here's the little compilation, a little encouraging video for you guys. And I will talk to you again soon. God bless and shalom.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag. I'm gonna make this place yours.